Credit scoring has much to offer to microfinance institutions and smaller banks. It is a simple and powerful tool in reducing operational costs and loan losses. Moreover, it speeds up the loan request evaluation process, reducing costs and improving customer satisfaction. Who would not be interested? In this series of videos, we will discuss four simple credit scoring techniques. Expert approach, Bayesian scoring, logistic regression, and the Altman Z score. Our goal is to demystify the mathematics and logic behind these models. We will explain in plain terms the underlying principles. Using simple Excel models, we show how to use these techniques in practice. Even smaller institutions without sophisticated IT systems can put in place these scoring techniques. This second video in the series is about the Bayesian approach. Bayesian statistics is named after the 18th century British mathematician Reverend Thomas Bayes. For while his theories were forgotten, the recent rise of big data has inspired many to take a fresh look at their data collections and the Bayesian approach. So, what is Bayes' theorem about? Bayes' key finding is that probabilities change whenever new information becomes available. A little story is probably helpful here. Say, I am talking to you about a train trip I took yesterday and the person I met on the train. Without any further information, you, as a listener, do not know whether this person was a lady or a gentleman. Since half of the population consists of males and the other half of females, your starting assumption is that there is a 50% probability I was talking to a lady, and 50% to a gentleman. In my story, I give you crumbs of information. I mention that the person had long hair. Knowing that more females than males have long hair, the probability of the person being a lady goes up. Chances that the unknown person was a male go down. The next thing you learn is that the mystery person was wearing earrings. Again, the probability increases that the person was a female. More women than men wear this jewelry. The third bit of information I pass on is the fragrance the person was wearing, the French perfume Chanel. Again, the probabilities change. Knowing that the mystery person had long hair, was wearing earrings and used the Chanel perfume, it has become clear that this person was a lady. You notice that every time a crumb of information becomes available, the odds change. The mathematician Thomas Bayes came up with a simple formula that describes these changes in assumed probabilities. Key to Bayes' theorem is the statement that probabilities change whenever a new piece of information is received. In the example above, the initial probability, in the absence of any further information, for the passenger to be a female was 50%. Every time a new bit of information was released, we update our view on this probability. 1. Long hair. 2. Earrings. And 3. Perfume. We can easily see that the combination of these three characteristics makes very likely that indeed the person was a woman. Bayes' law calculates these combined probabilities. Crucial to this Bayesian approach is that we have data or estimates available on the complete population. What percentage of all people have long hair, and what percentage of the men and of the women? The same goes for the jewelry and perfume. Now back to microfinance and banking. Here we need to tackle a similar problem with a binary outcome. Will a new client fully reimburse the proposed loan? The lender needs to decide whether to accept this new client and approve the loan request. Say, our financial institution has 5% problem loans in its portfolio, and let's assume that this default probability also applies to a new client that knocks on the bank's door. Also, here, in the absence of further information, we shoulder the view that there is 5% default probability. Again, we have a binary outcome: either the client will in the end default on his obligations, or not. However, as more information on the new prospect becomes available, this assumed probability might change. Let us look at some data of a financial institution. We analyzed 1,000 historical loan records. Looking at the gender, we see that most clients are male. However, looking closer at the data, we see the majority of the defaulters are female. This is interesting information. It means that if a new loan applicant is female, the default risk goes up from 5% to 12%. On the other hand, a male borrower would present a default risk of just 2%. How to calculate this? In its general format, Bayes' law looks like this. In this type of formula, P something stands for the probability of something. The standing bar defines a condition. For instance, P A B is the probability that A occurs given or knowing B. In our case, we are looking for the probability of default, knowing that the new client is female. So, our assignment is to find an answer for the problem. Now, we can rewrite the formula. We are going to peel off the components one by one. Female, default, is the chance the client is female once a default has occurred. We saw that we had 50 defaulters, of which 36 were women. This probability is 72%. P, prior default, is the probability of default for all our borrowers. Our financial institution had 1,000 loans, of which 50 defaulted. This probability is 5%. P, female, is the last one. This is simply probability the client is female. We have 1,000 clients, of which 293 are female. So, this is about 29%. With all our numbers in place, we can calculate the probability that a client will default knowing she is a female. This turns out to be 12%. Let's see what is happening here. Our prior assumption for the default probability for a client is 5%. This is the average PD for our client base. However, knowing that the client is a woman changes our original assumption. The updated default probability becomes 12%. This is Bayes' rule in action, with a new bit of information coming in the probabilities change. Knowing that our new client is a woman changes the default probability. So, what is the probability of default knowing the client is a male? This equals the chance that the probability of being a male among the defaulters, multiplied by the overall probability of default and divided by the probability of being a male. We fill out the percentages. We see that knowing the client is a male reduces the default probability from 5 to just 2%. Now we understand the mechanism of Bayes' theorem. In the example at the start of our video, we talked about three crumbs of information pertaining to the gender of the unknown person, the hair, the earrings, and the perfume. As more information became available, we updated the probability. Back to banking. The prior 5% probability of default changes a new posterior probability of 2%. We could take another attribute and repeat this step. We could take, for instance, our client's industry sector and see how it impacts our PD. The posterior we just found becomes the prior for the new cycle. Before we calculate the new posterior PD, we take a fresh look at the Bayes formula and see whether we understand the formula better now. Often the arguments in the Bayes formula are named as follows: posterior, likelihood, prior and evidence. We see the prior and posterior in the formula. The prior is the probability of default before, and the posterior the probability of default after the new piece of information arrives. In our initial example, the portfolio PD was 5%. Knowing that the client was a woman produced a new posterior PD of 12%. The likelihood is the reverse of the posterior P, A knowing B, so P, B knowing A. In our example, we tried to calculate the PD knowing the client is a female. Then the likelihood argument becomes the probability that the client is a woman, knowing the client defaulted. You see, it is the other way round. The last argument we need to explain is the evidence. Since our calculation pertains just to the female clients, we need to divide by the probability that the client is a woman. Returning to our loan dossier, we could ask to check whether the business sector impacts the client's PD. Knowing our client's business sector will impact the probability of default. We see that the sectors commerce and industry present higher PDs. Let us turn to Excel to create a Bayesian model that predicts the default probability of male entrepreneur in the agricultural sector. It is simple to put this in an Excel model. Now we add a second step. We know that the client is a male and that he works as a farmer. We start with the likelihood, the chance that the client works in agriculture, given that he defaulted. The total number of defaulters was 50, we see that there are 4 in the agricultural sector. So, the probability is 8%. The prior is simple. This is the outcome of the first step. We saw that the default probability, knowing the client is a man, equals 1.98%. Now we turn to the denominator. This is the evidence. In the previous examples we focused on the gender. We reduced the evidence to just the male or the female clients. In the case at hand, the evidence consists of the agricultural entrepreneurs that are male. Let's for now focus on the agricultural sector. Looking at our data we see that 4 of the 50 defaulters are farmers. This equals 8%. We see that 178 of the 950 non-defaulters are farmers. This equals 18.74%. Now we need to consider the gender component. We need to zoom in on the males. In the first step we calculated the default probability for the men. This equaled 1.98%. By multiplying we get the combined probability. We saw that 8% of the defaulters were farmers. Now, we can do our Bayesian calculation. We find that the probability of default for a man working in agriculture is just 0.85%. Let's take a look at the steps. 1. Nothing is known, PD equals 5%. 2. Gender, the client is a man, PD equals 1.98%. 3. Business sector, the client is a farmer, PD 0.85%. We see how in every step the probabilities are updated. With the right data we get a good idea of how Bayes' rule works. This Bayesian scoring is a powerful tool in banking and microfinance. It works best for larger datasets. In practice this means large volume, low monetary value loans. The nice thing about the Bayesian approach is that it makes use of the financial institution's own data. The scoring rules are derived from the bank's specific data set and the model is hence made to measure. This is a big advantage over standardized scoring techniques that usually do not follow the intricacies of the local bank. The scoring is also objective. The data speak and there is no human judgment involved. Moreover, the system is self-learning. As the data change, so will the behavior of the model. In our previous video on expert scoring, we explained how to use a score in the decision-making process. From experience, we know that although Bayes' theorem is simple, the full meaning is hard to grasp. Working in Excel and trying to do the calculations will certainly help. At least you should have a good idea how Bayesian statistics work. We end with listing the advantages of Bayesian credit scoring. Easy to implement without sophisticated IT systems. Based on the financial institution's own data and is hence a bespoke model. Self-learning. Objective, the data speaks. Provides a clear numerical outcome for decision making. Can be combined with other scoring techniques or human decision making. Can be integrated in a workflow approach for loan requests. Good luck.